We are in for a special treat this weekend. The moon will be moving right in front of the sun, blocking sunlight and creating a fantastic ring of fire in the sky.
This is an annual eclipse, and it's not the solar eclipse, but we'll soon have one of those soon enough. Here to talk about how to safely view this eclipse and what other solar events are on the horizon, NASA expert Jessica Collis. Jessica, thanks so much for joining us today.
Hi, how are you today?
We're doing great. So NASA is launching 3 rockets during the annual eclipse. What are you guys hoping to study and gather from this launch?
Yeah, absolutely. So NASA is launching 3 rockets in New Mexico, White Sands, New Mexico, which will happen during the beginning, the peak, and the end of the eclipse, which will allow us to study how the atmosphere changes during the eclipse and what happens during that time in the solar energy.
Very cool. So you guys also released the 2023 Eclipse Explorer online. What's included in this really cool interactive experience?
Yeah, so on there you can see the path of totality and everyone that's going to get a full annular eclipse and who's going to get a partial solar eclipse. So you can go on there and be able to view where exactly you are on the map and see what time it happens and how long it'll progress over time.
Yeah, I have it pulled up right here on
it is really,
our laptop. It really is cool.
Yeah, you can see exactly the path. But let's talk about the one that is coming next year, the total solar eclipse, and the one happening this weekend, which is an annual eclipse, commonly referred to as a ring of fire. Explain the difference here.
Yeah, so next year in April, the total solar eclipse is where it's at. The moon is at its peak and it'll cover the sun completely. And you'll be able to see the sun's corona. This year, you'll only get a partial and it'll look like Pac-Man is eating the sun. So or a cookie, you're taking a bite out of a cookie.
The eclipse this year, it fits right with Halloween.
Right, I was going to say, it's like timing.
It's perfect. Right. And it's Friday the 13th today.
Hey, so. There we go. Now, it's really awesome spectacle to watch, but if we want to see it, why do we need to do it safely and how can we do that?
Absolutely. So you always want to emphasize that you should never look at the sun directly on any given day, even during an eclipse. So you want to make sure that you are viewing with solar viewing glasses or a pinhole projector or a strainer from your home.
Strainer, oh.
So there's a lot of different ways that you can view this, but you gotta watch out for your eyes. So how are you celebrating this eclipse tomorrow? And is the weather gonna be good where you are? Because here it's gonna be kind of cloudy.
Yeah, so definitely DC is gonna be a little bit cloudy, but I missed the 2017 total eclipse due to being deployed. So I'm having a rooftop party and we're all gonna view and watch since we get to see it over for 2 years.
Oh, Jessica, we better come over there.
I was gonna say, where's the invite? That's perfect.
That is awesome.
But the Ring of Fire is gonna be a really fun eclipse to see and you can watch it our time, I think 8 to about 9:30 tomorrow morning. And it's just a fantastic spectacle. And you guys get to see it there in Washington too, right?
We do, yes. Like I said, it'll be over a span of 2 hours, so it'll slowly look like the moon's eating away at the sun.
Awesome. Cool. Jessica, thank you so much for joining us.